Today is December 29th. It's an emergency rundown. It's Black Monday in the NFL. I don't even know what that means, but we got a couple bums, a couple losers on the rundown who can tell us all about it and what they feel. So we thought we'd throw together an emergency Christmas miracle, New Year's miracle rundown. Hank, is it too echoey in here?
No, because they're talking about
it. Okay, but I'm echoey. Okay, whatever. KFC, we're going to start with the Jets. They fired everybody. What are the thoughts?
It's a dark day here. I got my candlelight vigil going for my boy Rex. It's a move that I knew was coming. It's a move that I wanted to come. It was time to move on, time to go. But as soon as it happened, I was sad. I didn't expect to be as sad as I was. I quickly realized there's never been Barstool New York without Rex. He's been here since day one. He's been endless blog material, good, bad, and everything in between. There's never been a KFC and never been a Barstool in New York without Rex. So we're, it's the end of an era here on the stool as well. He needed to go, but it's just sad because he was a fucking fun, great personality that I don't think will be replaced.
Quick
Hopefully
question
a better coach comes in, but I don't think he can replace his personality.
Quick question before we move to Dan. The fact that you hear so many other teams saying we're interested in Rex and they think he's a good coach and he just had bad talent, like, does that make you nervous? Like, if
not,
Rex
not really.
Goes-
I do think that he'll end up on his feet. I do think there's, of course, an element of, like, if he ever had a real quarterback, he would have been a lot better off. I mean, you even see it when Geno played well yesterday. This team can compete. So, yeah, if they fell into the right quarterback, I think Rex could have stuck around and been good. But unfortunately, that's a really hard problem to fix. And I think that period, no matter what, his time came and went. You can't have four straight seasons of no playoffs where you regress every single year. You can't give the guy three GMs, three quarterbacks, endless OCs, and never put the blame on him. So I agree that it's a little scary, and I do think he'll actually succeed elsewhere. But his time in New York came to an end, period.
Big Cat?
First, before we get to the Bears, I just want to say, savvy move by Dave. This is why they call him El Presidente. He had Hank send him a fake email being like, hey, Dave, should we do a rundown today? When in reality, clearly he just called this emergency rundown so he could rub Harbaugh in all of our faces. No one's better than you, babe. That's why you're the boss. That's why you're the best. So congrats on that little golf clap for you.
I did not send that email, and I haven't even mentioned Harbaugh.
Okay, all right. Bears, we're the flip side of Kevin. This was a firing that everyone wanted and everyone needed because the guys who were in charge were such a fucking joke and a dysfunctional mess. Unlike Kevin, the Bears actually spent money this offseason. They, tried to fix the holes, we're going to try to make a run in it, and it all fell apart. It all fell apart in a perfect way in Minnesota yesterday without a single touchdown being scored. So good riddance, fuck them all. And then right after, Kyle Orton slips out the back door with the old Irish goodbye, which might be the most epic way to retire of all time, to just tell the reporters, like, oh, I'll be right back, and then just fucking hits the road, and all you get is dust.
He's like the Goodwill Hunting of the NFL. He just disappeared one day.
Speaking of that retirement, and this is a little off subject, what's it? Doug Marrone, right? That's the guy's first name. What's he doing? Like, that's a question you had. He drafted EJ Manuel, didn't he?
Yeah.
So how? What do you?
No. EJ was there.
Is this his first? I thought he drafted him.
No, this is his first year, I believe.
Okay. Well, then, I mean, EJ Manuel should just walk into oncoming traffic. I mean, when you can't play in meaningless games as a rookie over a guy who's literally retiring, then it's time to go. And by the way, the Buffalo Bills, with one of the all-time tweets from their, like, actual Twitter account yesterday, said, first win at Gillette, check. And they had the check mark. The Patriots didn't try. It's just an unbelievable thing for the Bills. I don't know whether it was like a reverse troll to get people like me be like laugh out loud or what they're doing, but interesting move by the Bills Mafia. As far as Rex goes, you know, I think he's a D coordinator. I agree with what you said. I like Rex. I agree with what you said, Kevin. It's like you can't always shed the blame. And he has such a force of personality. I have a hard time believing like they just ignored him when they were drafting people or making decisions. So at some point, it is on his lap. And I mean, they were getting worse and worse and worse. It's
and
fun.
Every quarterback he's had has regressed. I mean, there's a lot of different factors.
Whoa! Geno was perfect yesterday.
God, I swear to God, if that gives him more slack, I'm going to kill someone. It's just Rex, he's stuck in that no man's land. He's better. He's a little better than a D coordinator. Not good enough to run the whole show because he doesn't know the offensive side of things. So he's in that NFL limbo. I actually hope he just kind of swallows his pride and takes the job as a D coordinator because I don't know if he can ever really be a head coach again, and I think he'd be better if he's in this league.
The fact that his brother has a job and he doesn't right now is such a joke.
Yeah.
The Saints were like the worst defense in the league this year. And I think I would take Rex on the Bears in a second because that's the kind of guy – like.
As a head coach?
Well, specifically you. Yeah.
I think him as a head coach.
Coming in after Trestman.
Yeah.
Like that's the type where you need to shed the nerd and bring in the personality of Rex. I don't know, you know, again, the X's and O's and everything may not all work out, but to get rid of that Trestman stink,
Trestman is like the worst. Trestman is the worst case scenario because he's a dumb nerd. You can't be a dumb nerd. If you're going to be a nerd, you got to be a genius.
Right.
I think Rex would probably make the Bears competitive and plateau, kind of like you did with the Jets. Anyways, let's move on to the next one. And you can slice this. There's all these firings today. Black Monday, the playoffs are starting. Bowl games are starting. As a side note, I'm red hot gambling. I mean, like, in fuego. And I haven't put a dime on the game. Anyways, the story that is trumping everything. I don't care whether another Ferguson happened tomorrow. This would be the number one story in America. Still, is Jim Harbaugh is apparently going to take the job, and you've heard different reports. He's on a plane. He's going to give the press conference at the Michigan basketball game tomorrow. But it seems like I was right in that Michigan always gets their man, the number one coach that every college football team, that every NFL team, every World League team, the coach everybody wants, the number one coach who's available has gone to Michigan, which despite what you two have said for a long time, just proves the one thing that I've been saying nonstop. Michigan matters. Tradition matters. Being a Michigan man matters. And right now, Big Cat, I don't know what you're going to say. You should be the happiest guy in this room beside me because guess what? The Big Ten matters now. The Midwest matters now. Wisconsin, you know who Wisconsin just became? Missouri. They're going to be that team on the other side of the Big Ten that can show up against Ohio State or Michigan and get blown out. But they're going to get their shine. They'll get their national shine. So it's great. It's a great day to be a Michigan man. I don't know if you guys have anything to add. I just want to move on and say, you know what? It's like that Rod Stewart song that I posted today. You know, some guys have all the luck. My team's going to the Super Bowl. My team's got the best quarterback. Everything is coming up page views. KFC?
You're right. You're right. I can't say anything about it. He was the most coveted guy. He turns around programs. He's got a proven track record. He's a winner. I would love to try to shit on this somehow, some way, but you are the big winner here. It's a guy that I would have loved to go to the Jets. I'm sure it's a guy Big Cat would have loved on the Bears. I can't spin it. This is a no-spin zone. You're right. You win, Dave. It's another example of Portnoy selling his soul. It's like you had one little blip on the radar with Michigan football, but Satan comes through once again and hooks you up because you sold your soul to him.
Big Cat?
The only thing that's disappointing with this whole experience is that I love Harbaugh. Like, I deeply love him. And you don't. You don't. You pretend you do, but you don't.
No, I do now.
No, yeah, I know you do now. But I've been like, I'm a Harbaugh fan when he has nothing to do with any of my teams. That's how much I love Harbaugh. This was classic Skip Portnoy. Tape don't lie. You said one day that Michigan always gets their man, and the next day you said that he's going to stay in the NFL and he wants to win a Super Bowl. So just like Skip Bayless, you just make both sides of the prediction. Then you stand up and say you were right. That's fine. The tape literally doesn't lie on that one. It sucks, though. I love Harbaugh.
Yeah, I mean, I did say it's a simple thing. I was rattled by being wrong about Lester, and I didn't want to jinx it. So that's what I did. I didn't want to be that guy who put all my mojo by saying he was definitely coming. So I came back just to even and let it play out naturally. Because if I let it play out naturally, I know what happens. We get our guy.
Can I ask one question? What happened? Who was your source that said Dan Mullen? Because you said, according to your sources, it's Dan Mullen. It's in the books. So your source is looking like an asshole.
That was, if we didn't get him, that was just a random Twitter guy. And again, I was trying to throw that. That's how above the game. That's how far above the rim I play. I was just trying to throw the scent off because that Lester thing rattled me. I thought we had him. I was wrong. I didn't want to be wrong. Just let God in the natural course take its root and let us just get the Michigan man. I do think eventually he'll go back to the NFL, but not after we win a national championship and he leaves us in great stead. I think a lot of NFL guys are upset, by the way, because it just elevated Michigan to almost a more prestigious institution than the NFL. And I see, like, the NFL articles being like, oh, he'll come back, still college, blah, 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 he didn't get the money. Just, I mean, Michigan is, you know, football. That's all there is to it.
I'm just praying, and I don't know when this will air. He'll probably be already in Ann Arbor, but I'm just praying that fucking weird creep in Oakland, Mark Davis with his bowl haircut, literally locks Jim Harbaugh in, like, in the stadium and doesn't let him leave. Like, I'm just praying that that's what's going on right now. And he's got him, like, in a cage, and he's going to fucking hold him, like, gunpoint. What's that movie? Celtic Pride?
Yeah, yeah.
It's going to be like that. Mark Davis is going to make Jim Harbaugh coach the Raiders next year with a gun in his back.
I that's the only reason I haven't said it's official, because and people are asking, when are you going to blog it? The blog is written. It's beautiful. I've read it like 100 times. I have the Schembechler team speech in there. I have the fight song in there. I have Harbaugh from his playing days. It's just a beautiful, beautiful blog, but I'm holding it back till it's official. I don't want to jinx anything, but I think it's 99.9% sure that Michigan got their man. And seriously, though, it is great for the Big Ten. You should be happy.
Shut up.
That's like the truest thing I could possibly say. We're saving the Big Ten. Johnny Football, this guy. So Football came out with these quotes that said he has to take his job more seriously in the NFL. He's turning the page. He's going to be much more serious. Literally less than 24 hours later, he supposedly throws this gigantic party, which he denies he did, by the way. But he's not denying he went out and got shit-faced and overslept. The bizarre thing is he didn't wait like one day, but when their season's over, he has since come forward and said once again, I got to stop being a jackass for the second time in 48 hours. What do we got on Football here, Big Cat?
Well, I think he's doing what I expected him to do, and that's that he knows his shine is about to – the shine is coming off the star, and he's not going to be a good quarterback next year. Like, I said that he would be somewhere in that, like, Jeff Garcia, you know, Doug Flutie journeyman, kind of always undersized, always, you know, not credited. But I might take it down a notch because I the two games I watched, he looked lost. And he might be like, oh, wow, I can't hack it at this level. So I might as well throw some bangers before I become, you know, some Joe Blow who's playing in the CFL.
KFC?
Tiger can't change his stripes. Leopard can't change his spots. I believe he wants to. I really think he actually wants to buckle down and try hard and succeed. He just literally can't. It's in his DNA. It's in his blood. It's like how every weekend you're like, all right, diet starts Monday, and you just fucking go nuts, and you never follow through on anything. He's like an average guy who just happened to have this incredible college career. Otherwise, I mean, I said it from the jump. I don't think he'll ever be a Pro Bowl quarterback, and I don't think there's anything to back up anything otherwise.
I still think he will, but I think, you know, like a tiger can't change his stripes. I don't think Johnny planned on going out till the minute – like he was like, fuck it, let's go. And then he was, I'm only going to have one drink. I'm only going to have two drinks. I'm only going to have six drinks. I'm not going to talk to that girl. I'm not going to have this fucking eightsome in the hot tub. And it just devolves. You can't go out, Johnny. That's the thing. You got to go cold turkey, but he's got his friends in from Texas. I know he was sitting on the couch all day being like, no, I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't do it. And then they're getting ready to walk out the door. And he's just like, fine, I'll fucking come for a drink. So I still don't think his partying is any reflection on whether he's going to be a very good pro. I still have faith in you, Johnny. What?
You don't think if he can't like physically just stay in for one night, you don't think that will have any effect on his pro career?
I think he would not have gone out if he was playing.
I also like that. I don't know if you saw his quote or whatever he was saying that he didn't. Josh Gordon didn't come to his party.
Right.
But they were at the same party at the same time at one point in the night.
Like, Cleveland's a small town. There's only so many bars or clubs you can go to in Cleveland.
It's just funny that he's fighting like semantics on whether Josh Gordon fucking partied.
That makes sense. You see someone out at a bar that you didn't like text her. It's like, oh, hey, what's up, Josh? Fancy seeing you here. I believe it. But again, he was already out. He just looks bad. My point was, I don't think these incidents this year partying have anything to do with whether he's going to be a successful pro. If he's partying like that in missing walkthroughs on the day of the game when he's a starting quarterback, I will sing a different tune. Last up, Ndamukong Suh just got suspended for one game for stomping on Aaron Rodgers. KFC, what do you got on this decision? What do you got on the stomp? What do you got on the Dominic?
To use like another one-liner, if it looks like a duck, it walks like a duck. Like, this is what Ndamukong Suh does. I feel like, to break it down, I feel like if he really didn't know he was stepping on Aaron Rodgers, he would have like stumbled and tripped a little more. He like perfectly maintained his balance while he stepped on his ankle. He's a guy who's done Bush League shit like this a million times before. And I think for anybody else, a one-game suspension in the playoffs would be really harsh. But again, this guy has done this like 10 fucking times now. So I think any penalty the NFL wanted to throw out, they're kind of justified in.
Big Cat?
Before I talk about Sue, let me just say this. The acting job that Aaron Rodgers put on yesterday, he should win every fucking Oscar for the rest of time. Standing in the tunnel, not coming out in the second half with his team, stretching while the camera's on him, waiting for Matt Flynn to go three and out, and then coming back in the game. Fucking Joe Buck is like literally sucking his dick on air, saying he's like Willis Reed. Willis Reed, I think Willis Reed like leg died. Aaron Rodgers had a cramp in his calf.
Also, the grabbing of the beard was calculated.
Grabbing the beard, it's all calculated, and all those stupid Packer fans suck it all up and think he's the funniest, coolest guy, and that he's so gutsy and he came out there and put the team on his back. He wasn't even injured. Fuck him. So Sue's a scumbag, but I wish he had stomped on his face.
I am team Ndamukong Suh. I like this guy. I think he's a monster. And now I fully admit what I'm about to say has fallacies and logic, because I hate Dominic Raiola, who's dirty. But I like Sue, and I think that play was in the realms of you can defend your dirtiness. He has the history, but this was like, oh, I stepped on him, and I kind of didn't know what I was doing, and there's no way to prove it. And there's cameras everywhere. Dick Butkus, by all accounts, was like the dirtiest football player in the history of the NFL. Everything Sue does, everything anybody does, is under a camera. But if I have a big, nasty defensive lineman, I want him to be dirty. I don't want him to be, like, friendly. I want him to stomp on guys. I think he should get away with it. If that suspension, to me, is ludicrous. If you have to suspend him for... Oh, he may not be a Lion. I guess that's the problem. But to take your best player out of the playoff game over that, I have a real problem with that. Because again, yes, he's a dirty guy. Yes, he did it on. He clearly did it on purpose. But yes, that one you could say, I didn't know. It wasn't that blatantly crazy obvious.
But the ones in the past have been. Like, yeah, that's the problem.
True.
And I don't mind his dirtiness either. I agree with everything you said. Like, football's a dirty, nasty sport, and I want a nasty guy. I just want a guy who's smart about it. And he's this time, he kind of was smart about it. Unfortunately, the past 10 times, he's been so dumb and so blatant that I really can't fault the NFL for anything they decided.
Right. The only thing with that play, which I'll say is, like, when Dominic Riola took a shot at our guy's knees, that was pre-planned. Like, it was a, you know, it wasn't in the middle of play. He snapped the ball and dove at our guy's knees to try. This, Sue just happened to wind up, like, near his leg. He's like, ooh, he just doesn't like him. It's the game. I don't know. He didn't, like, stomp it. He stepped on it. I mean, if he stomped it, Rodgers probably would be injured. But he wasn't. That, to me, is not worthy of possibly a game-changing playoff game. I mean, that's huge that he's not in the game.
I think Sue's a scumbag, and he has passed. He should get – it just sucks that it's a playoff game.
Right.
Because he really should get suspended for it because he did do it on purpose, and you know he did it on purpose because of his past experiences. And you can't tell me – like, players – football players spend their life – making sure they don't step on things to, like, turn their ankle and stuff. They're very aware of their surroundings. So you know he was there.
Absolutely.
It just sucks that it was a playoff game. I agree with you there. I want to see the best players play on a playoff game.
I don't think that particular incident, and I'm thrown out, I guess, I don't think that incident was worthy of a suspension for a playoff game. I think a hefty fine, but it just sucks to lose your best player for the playoffs. So that's the rundown. This will be the last rundown before the new year. Harbaugh tomorrow, supposedly. I don't know. That's really all we got. You guys have anything else?
Goodbye, Rex.
Michigan fans wearing their khakis. They're doing a khaki out tomorrow night. I almost puked on my computer when I saw that.
Yeah, they're doing a khaki out. They're doing a khaki. I mean, it's a huge get. Everyone, I mean, I think I saw Feinbaum say this is the same as, like, Saban going to Alabama. I mean, it redefines the shape. That's why you should be happy. You're laughing, but it's we're going to put the big.
I'm not laughing. I haven't laughed once.
I've said this from the beginning. The Big Ten needs Michigan. Without a powerful Michigan, that's what the Big Ten's problem is. So, you know, we're back. We're back.
Michigan's going to have, like, one good season, and you're going to say that Michigan saved the Big Ten. This is the worst case scenario for me.
But it's true.
You're going to take credit for, like, literally revitalizing Michigan, the Big Ten, college football, America's economy. Like, you're going to take credit for all of that.
I'm not saying America's economy, but I did say the Midwest.
The entire Midwest.
It wouldn't shock me if, like, the auto industry came back to Detroit. It honestly wouldn't. When Michigan football is good, the Midwest is a different place.
God damn it. This is.
And you live in the Midwest. That's why you should be happy.
I know. But it's just like you taking credit for all of it is just, it's painful. It's the worst case scenario. Kevin always says it, and it's the truth. Like, you're going straight to hell. The deal you made with the devil is unbelievable.
Well, it is what it is.
While you're on earth.
We're going to put this behind us after the press conference, and Jim will get to recruiting, and then I got to concentrate on the playoffs. I'm trying to get to that golf tournament tickets. Anybody for that Waste Management Open in Scottsdale, we're looking for a couple passes in the drinking area. So any stoolies out there live in that area, let us know.
Should we pick our Super Bowl right now? Now that we got the playoff tree.
Yeah, you can. I think we're all going to have the same Super Bowl.
Who do you have, Dave? The Seahawks and the Patriots?
Yeah. Patriots beat the Seahawks in a very close, like 21-24 to like 17 game.
I actually think the Cowboys can do it. Oof. Come around. I'm rooting for the Cowboys.
I could see the Cowboys. That one shocked me.
I know that we're almost probably going to throw a back-breaking interception, and it's going to be hilarious. I'm going to have so much fun laughing about it. But it would be kind of cool to see Jerry back in the big stage just fucking everyone and, like, boozing and doing crazy shit. Like, as a blogger, that's the story I kind of want.
I mean, the Cowboys over the Pats would be the greatest fucking thing to ever watch. It would be the greatest thing for any stoolie outside of New England.
I'd much rather play the Cowboys than the Seahawks from Patriots' perspective.
I would agree with that.
And this isn't me being a homer. I don't see any possible way in hell the Patriots don't at least make it to the Super Bowl. I think the Super Bowl will be a challenge, whoever they play. But the AFC, they're stumbling over each other. I don't see anybody giving us. And I know Baltimore generally plays. This is a much different Baltimore team. People are comparing this to other teams.
No, the only team that I would say has a chance is Pittsburgh, to be honest. Yeah. Denver is like Peyton Manning. Doesn't even look like he's played football.
No matter what, if somehow someone else in the AFC wins, it's a huge fluke and a huge upset. There's no actual competition.
Yeah. All right. Well, everybody have a good Happy New Year. And we wish you the best in 2015. And you know, go Patriots, go Blue. That's it.